I mean, I know we're a band that needs no introduction, but I did think we'd get one.
Yes, it's going to be one of those those afternoons, folks.
That's all right. We're going to keep things happy, aren't we?
That's right. We have a lot of happiness today. And this first song is by request. 1, 2, 3, 4. Smell worse than socks, worse than hell. Car is broke, wife's a joke, boss is bad, son's on coke, belts are red, Jack's instead, mining drills in my head. The only thing that I can do is go by words so very true, where some hobo came and said to me, he said, when you're feeling low and down, when you're feeling upside down, long and join with me, find your heart and set it free, watch it lift and get so high, beyond the scrapers in the sky, watch it turn and spin for all night long, say thanks now man, cause you know of the happy song. Because he did not get written into Oni the Runaway Circus Bear, a rock opera. So we're just going to have to kind of breeze past that part.
Okay. Right?
1, 2, 3, 5.
The happy song. It's the happy song.
That's our happy opener.
Yes.
Happy con. Happy song, happy con, happy show. We're all so happy.
Even the banister's happy. Okay, one guy got that.
Oh, one person.
We have one Rocky Horror fan in the entire house. Okay, we're going to be scratching Time Warp off the list. Okay. Joke's on you. Time Warp wasn't on the list.
That's not but saying it couldn't have been.
Not saying it couldn't.
We did that. Was it just last year? What was Trick or Treat? Last year?
Yes.
We did Time Warp, right?
Oh, yes. We did.
Okay, good. So we were not remiss.
All right, so if we really need to hold these people hostage to get the charity donations up, we know what song to play.
Oh, there we go. Requests for charity. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't have any liquor, so we're not going to do Fox and Pepper level. Well, Alkali and Boozy, you know.
No.
Getting drunk for charity.
Yeah, we can't do this show when we're drunk.
I can barely do it sober. I'm too old for that disco shit. Sorry, didn't mean to swear. Where were we? Shit, that's right. Okay. We have a new little ditty that we'd like to dedicate to the con's theme.
That's right.
And I'll talk a little bit more about that after we do this.
Yes, we always like to be timely.
Yes.
We like to be, whether we are or not.
So much to see and do.
There's the pizza feed, the dealers, and the masquerade, and a ton of other stuff too, all together.
At the Tiki 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 Con, at the Tiki 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 Con,
we've got lots of soda, but the chili's gone.
At the Tiki 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 Con,
we're so glad you have us back every year. Your affection can't be beat.
If we weren't show singing here for you, we'd be in that Florida heat. At the Tiki 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 Con, at the Tiki 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 Con,
you can follow us on Blue Sky or Mastodon.
At the Tiki 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 Con, here in the friendly no drama zone, we all try to get along.
If you're looking for some controversy, stick around for our Pepper Coyote song. That's later.
At the Tiki 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 Con, at the Tiki 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 every Tiki Con,
appearance every year is a sing con non.
At the Tiki 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 Con, at the Tiki 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 Con, at the Tiki 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 Con, where the weekend's short and the lines are long. I mentioned we wrote the words for that. I did not specifically mention that we had also not really practiced it. Sometimes...
No one cares.
Inspiration just hits at, 10 minutes to showtime.
Yes.
All right.
And sometimes 10 minutes after, which is a lot more
awkward.
And, hey, everyone, come back. We got a great idea.
Or in the middle of a show, we just start detouring. But
That has never happened.
That never happened to us. Cons are they're just little microcosms of germs and viruses and illnesses and things. And especially recently, last year, look what y'all did to Alex not wearing masks. You almost killed him. But there is something, especially, we've learned this a lot because we actually did two overseas cons in the last year.
Yes.
Not necessarily by design. We knew we wanted to go back to Eurofrance because we had been there, 8 years ago now. And Rhubarb, as we have mentioned, wrote this thing called Oni, the Runaway Circus Bear. And so we had done, y'all have seen pieces of it here. We did back in 2019.
Yeah, 2019. We did a work in progress.
Like a work in progress. So we did like, you know, selections from it. And so we took pretty much most of the show to Eurofrance last year so we could try it out away from all those American reviewers because they have poison pens and, you know, y'all and Twitter. And we didn't want anyone to say anything bad about it. And Germans don't understand what we're saying. So they go, yay, music! So we took that there, but they liked it so much that Nordic FuzzCon up in Malmö, Sweden, invited us to come perform it, and they said, and do it with a live band. And what? And a live band suddenly volunteered, and they were like, send us the recording, and we'll learn it off of that. And they did, and they learned it better than we did.
They really did.
So, no worries there, but this is something that we have learned. By attending Eurofrance and Nordic FuzzCon. And that is that when you're attending fur cons overseas, you've got to know your secret enemies. So duty makes us say, these fears we must convey to each and every one of you today. The people you meet may not be discreet. In every deck there's a joker, so don't take a chance on cheap romance. You don't want to dance the con crud polka. Now when you see a suit and you think it's really cute, look out for the good time fur. As you feast your eyes on the thickness of those thighs, look out for the good time fur. When you're at a dance and you think you found romance, 'cause they snuggle till they make you purr. You may only want to scritch, but chlamydia's a bitch. Look out for the good time purr. Oh, when you're on the prowl and you want to start a howl, look out for that good time purr. Though their suit looks clean and they promise they're 18, look out for the good time fur. In the party suite, when you're searching for some heat and you're drinking till it's all a blur, although you swoon and sigh, you'll end up on CSI. Look out for the good time fur. Forget all the furry drama and the politics, all because of a video called Room 366. Go, 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 go slow when you're thirsty. Don't just attack the fur that you first see. Although you want to sin there, you don't know what's been in there. Look out for the good time fur. They may make you feel all iffy, but trust us, folks, they're iffy. Look out for the good time fur. Just be careful or you betcha, that con crud's gonna getcha. Look out for the good time, look out for the good time, look out for the good time first. Woo! I'm telling you, also hydrate. Hydrate, that helps a lot. When they told me this theme last year, I immediately went, Hawaii, it's a Hawaiian theme. And I prepared all this Hawaiian stuff. And then I got here and he said, no, it's just general tropical islands. You know, the founders, you know, they had Jamaican food. I thought, that's not Hawaii, but you know. But apparently there was lots of coconut and pineapple and everything, yeah. So, and guavas. And yeah. I'm like, you know, they have all that in Hawaii.
I'm from Missouri, I couldn't tell.
You know, look like barbecued ribs to me. I just really enjoy Hawaii. I got, when I graduated university, my gift was that my parents got me a plane ticket so I could fly out to Hawaii and stay with my sister and brother-in-law who were stationed there at the time with their kids. My brother-in-law is now my ex-sister-in-law, but that's a whole nother story that explained an awful lot about what was going on at the time, but it was just absolutely beautiful there. You go to McDonald's and you can get guava juice And they have saimin. Does anyone know what saimin is? It's very much like ramen, but they have you can get like a side of ramen noodles at McDonald's in Hawaii. It's just great. Coincidentally, I had a college classmate and a fraternity brother who decided to go out to Hawaii, and he did his hotel management internship there and liked it so much that he just stayed, and he's been managing a resort hotel properties on the island of Maui. And as you probably know, the island of Maui was recently devastated by wildfires. And I'm gonna take this down a step.
Okay.
Because as you can hear, my voice is lowering as we speak. Just a lot of talking all weekend. I don't know why I said I would do a panel. I talked for an hour yesterday. But anyway, this is just this lovely song that I learned when I was in Hawaii. And so I'd like to dedicate it to the victims and their families, and pray for a speedy recovery for the island of Maui and Hawaii. Weird to say I have a favorite Hawaiian band, but I do, and their names are the Brothers Casimero. They're from Oahu. They perform at, I think it's the Royal Hawaiian. I'm not sure. I've never gotten to see them live. I did not get to, because I just discovered them when I was out there back in 1989. And there's this giant pink hotel, I think is called the Royal Hawaiian. And they play there every night, but that's one of the songs they do, and just beautiful stuff. Talk to them a minute, because I'm going to go back and get a cup of water for both of us, because I know I need one. Or you could bring water down to us.
Okay.
There we go. Oh, look at that. See, Sydney's on it.
Man, this is service.
Yes. Thank you. Oh my God, I love your nails.
Yeah.
All right, yeah. Ooh, that's going to feel good.
Yeah, this is actually quite a bit different than our last performance as Cosmik and Rhubarb, which was in Sweden, and
very cold in Sweden.
Yes, very cold. And mostly what I remember was afterwards, people were saying, "You're so funny. You're the funniest people we've ever heard." And I thought, "What was so funny about it?" Because, like, the microphone would go down and you'd sing a song about there being no microphone. And you were just making it up. It didn't exist before.
In Sweden, they haven't heard of improvisation.
Yeah. In Sweden, you go by the book. I
and then you read out of it.
Yeah.
That was an improv. I made that joke up just now. You're welcome, kids. They just get daddier.
Yes.
I know some of you are into that.
Woo!
I don't know. Anyway.
And that's good because our microphones are working perfectly today. We can't actually riff on that.
They're not falling out of the stands.
My microphones is working so dang good today. Oh well, that's the song. It's not as good when things work. You have to wait
for the water.
Water.
He brought it to us just like he ordered. They start short, they get longer.
Longer.
Yeah, I know, nothing's gone wrong today. The mic hasn't fallen out of the mic holder like it did in Sweden.
No.
We've had great sound. We love our AV team. Hand for the AV team. Hand for Blue for helping us get all this put together. We give Blue a lot of grief, but it's all loving grief. We're eternally grateful that y'all have us back here every year to do a show, and no one's gotten tired of it yet. I don't think, well, no one in this room has gotten tired of it that I know of. Those that did aren't here. They just stopped coming to the con. Wilder, Bucktown, Flash. I mean, that's my takeaway, is they clearly got annoyed with us, and so they stopped coming. Calamity. Too soon? I'm sorry. I mean, we made a whole living out of pestering Calamity, and then when we lost Calamity, we had to transfer to Blue. We will try not to give you a heart attack. Okay, remember before when they said that half of your face is a little dark, and I said that's where I store my humor? It was not a joke. But anyway, here's a little song we wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Be furry. Be happy. I mean, great advice, right? It's a very happy song. The hotel plays it all day long. Be furry. Be happy. Be furry and happy. Oh, see, we've lost a whole row. Oh no, they're sitting down. They're just here early for the masquerade. Ain't got no place to lay your head. Try the overflow hotel instead. Be furry. Be happy. The sex room? Oh, sax. I don't know why I heard sex. At a fur con. This is not FWA. That's all right. Got no money to pay for food. Tanta's gonna feed you really good. Be furry. See, good rhymes with food in a Jamaican accent. See what I did there? I was trying to decide if I wanted to
We just got fine.
Don't worry, we're furry. At closing, get downstairs fast. Tiger's chili ain't gonna last. Be furry. Well fed. Be happy. But that's okay, man. If you miss that, don't kick and scream. At 8 o'clock, there's free ice cream. Be furry. Be happy. Just don't eat the strawberry shortcake bars till I get there. If you please, we've got them down on their knees. Be free. Be happy. There's another verse I tried to make about poppycock and batter cake. Be furry. Be happy, because that's all I could come up with. So this is the song we wrote. I hope that you learned it note for note. We'll play it for a minute 40 and then we'll play it again
and again and again.
Be furry. Be happy. Everybody with us. Oh, woo! It's been, the first two lines have been written for 5 years, and that's as far as it's gone. By the time I get right. to it, no one will remember Book of Mormon anymore. Book of Mormon. All right. It's yes. polka time.
It's polka time.
It's polka time.
Yes. Like it when we have new words.
Yeah. Oh, this is me. Bunny handles registration, though it's sometimes quite a mess. When a pre-reg from last year gets lost, this is how she handles stress.
Shelby takes care of her dealers. They do well, but truth be told, if they really wanted lots of cash, this is what they should have sold.
Schnapps is good for aches and pains, for cuts and bruises, stress and strains. Schnapps is good in every way. It made me what I am today. Have you tried Blue Healer's cookies?
Woo!
They're a tasty treat, you bet. But the more he bakes and gives away, the shorter his shorts get.
Schnapps is good for aches and pains, for cuts and bruises, stress and strains. Schnapps is good in every way. It made me what I am today.
There's a cowboy named of Tiger who adores his faithful staff. 'Cause whenever someone starts to bitch, they say this on his behalf.
Schnapps is
We've written other verses and kind of discarded them. Sometimes it's because the drama has already moved on.
Yes.
Sometimes it's because they're not ready. But... Okay, we're going to test our improv skills.
All right.
Kill time. At this, I don't know what they call it. At the boozegasm thing on Friday, they give out much malort. As we've come to learn, it's Tiger Cowboy's favorite drinking sport. Schnapps, it's good for aches and pains, for cuts and bruises, stress and strains. Schnapps is good in every way. It made me what I am today.
Woo!
There you go. We're not always quick, but we'll always come up with something.
Mm. Like never.
That's right. I had a lovely encounter last night, just a conversation while I was out sewing in the hallway, and Flair came up and was chatting about the show, and Flair, you got your Kleenex out, because we're going to do that song again. I'm sorry, but not, because this is where we pay our annual tribute to friends that are no longer with us, and I make Rhubarb sing this. Mostly because it's too high for me.
It's not always sentimental, sometimes it's practical.
There are places I remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, and some remain. All these places have their moments with lovers and friends I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I've loved them. There is no one compares with you, and these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more.
We got some time to fill. Yes. How did that happen?
Well, it happened because we improv faster than we usually do.
It usually takes us much more time.
Yes, we got to everything right away. But that just means
we have time for
a sing-along.
Yeah.
Because the sing-along is something we do at a certain other con that we won't mention. He'll mention it.
Anthrocon.
Yeah.
We can say that, right?
Yes. But this is pretty much the defining event for that con is gathering in a panel room in the Westin and just letting everyone have at it with their requests. And fortunately, it's been like gray muzzle leaning enough that we actually know the songs.
Yeah. I wonder if I did. Okay. We haven't drugged this one out in a while, but okay. You will all know, you know the chorus, but okay, come here a second.
Oh, okay. We're rehearsing, folks.
Okay, the hybrid.
Yeah.
Okay, because y'all will know the choruses and we want everybody to sing along without howling.
Or maybe.
He's got orange cards and he will use them. Although I may put this one up in the charity auction next year. Who did?
Yes, but you didn't see the note I put on it.
Nor will he.
We'll have to check that out. Okay, are we ready?
Yes. This is inspired by my work at Epcot in Walt Disney World. It's 9 o'clock on a Saturday. The regular crowd shuffles near. There's a hot guy standing next to me, making love to his overpriced beer. He says, "Dude, can you play me Sweet Caroline? I promise we'll all sing along." And I try to produce some convincing excuse, 'cause the manager can't stand that song. It's a true story. Everyone knows this part, come on.
Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight. We're all in the mood for a melody, and you've got us feeling all right.
Yeah, when I started there at the pub in Epcot, they said, "You can play anything you want, doesn't matter, because you're a sub." And I thought, well, that's kind of lame. So I made sure that I played like all these British and Irish pub songs that I knew. I just had books of them home anyway. But they said, "There's only one song you can't play." And I said, "Oh, what's that?" They said, "Sweet Caroline," because everybody just starts singing along and the crowd gets really rowdy and the managers just hate that because they can't control everybody. And this is back when we were playing at night, so especially on a Saturday night, we would have to call security and get the drunk girls off the tables.
Oh my God.
It was just a mess.
Welcome to Disney.
Yes. Now Gavin at the bar is a friend of mine, and he gets me my drinks for free, 'cause I drink water, and he's quick with a joke or to light up your smoke, but then send you outdoors, 'cause that's where you have to be. He says, "Cause I believe this is killing me," and a smile ran away from his face. "But I'm sure I could work in merchandise if I could get out of this place." La da 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 da. La da 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 da. Novelist whatever the hell that is. He never had time for a wife,
cause he's gay.
And he's talking to Davey, who's still in the Navy and probably will be for life.
Also gay. Yes. Don't ask, don't tell.
That's right. And the waitress is practicing politics as the businessman slowly gets stoned on beer. They're sharing a drink they call loneliness, but it's better than drinking alone. That's what it's like working at an Epcot. Woo! You have one you wanna pull out? What was like? You remember it better than I. When I'm at Anthrocon, I'm so in the moment of just trying to play and get through the songs. I don't remember half of what I played. What did I just say about the manager?
The manager isn't here. These people want to go bop, bop, bop. I can tell. I don't know it, so you know what that means? We hope you guys know it.
Where it began, I can't begin.
Going through his iPad, the piano's still playing. This is professional skill.
Spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? I can only backspace one character at a time with each chord, or I mess myself up. Pre-COVID, hands. Touching hands. Now you need to sanitize or have a vaccine. Reaching out. Vaccines are good, y'all. Touching me, they save lives. Touching you, but not inappropriately. Sweet Caroline,
ba, ba, ba.
The good times never seem so good.
So good, so good.
sing the high stuff next time.
And it don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with only two. And when I hurt,
you hurt.
A hurt runs off my shoulders.
It's okay.
How can I hurt?
Some things that we must do every performance.
Yes, there's certain inevitable things like death and taxes and this song. We try and update this song.
We were really proud of that verse, by the way.
The problem is we spend so much time sitting around in the room trying to write words that we don't get to meet everyone.
Yes.
My first MFM was 12 years ago, 2011, and all I knew about furry cons was CSI.
Oh!
Now, it's true. But because it's me, not that. I walked in, and I thought there would be, like, a big poster board on an easel announcing that there would be a panel discussion about the etymology of the furry fandom at 11, and then at, like, 12:30, there would be some sort of, like, you know, peer-juried PhD report on the demographics of the furry fandom, lunch at 2 o'clock, that we, you know, everybody would just gather, you know, and that, like they had at CSI, right?
Yeah. I mean,
that wasn't
they were cringy, but they were on time.
Yeah, they were. All the dealers were in this one room cramped together. They weren't just sort of like out along the main hallway in the lobby displaying things. What was the other thing? Anyway, there were all these things. There was a schedule, and I thought, oh, okay, well, I'm going to try and get to every panel. That didn't happen. That never happens. Newcomers? Don't even try. Be in the moment. Be a con and just go, oh, this interesting thing seems to be happening. I'm going to do that.
Yes.
Don't wait too late at night, because then the interesting things that are happening, well, you'll need an ID to get into those. We'll get to that, too. Most of you have heard this story. I didn't know anything about MFM. I was living in Orlando. Rhubarb was still in Missouri, holding down the house that we had, or as we call it, the money pit, and working the jingle business, which was still thriving back then. And I said, hey, I have Labor Day weekend off. Why don't I drive home and we can hang out and have some time together? And he said, oh, I'm not going to be home Labor Day weekend. I'm going to this con. I thought, oh, like one of his business weekends where they go off and meet with radio station people and write jingles. And I said, this is great. Well, where's your con? I can go there and meet you. He said, it's in Memphis. And I said, okay, so like I could, you know, just hang out in the room or go walk downtown for a little while you do your business things. And then at night we can hang out together. And he says, oh, well, it's a furry con. And I said, so we can't hang out together? And I said, well,
you can come and we can get a room, but you're going to need to create an account on FA and create a fursona. So a week before MFM, I'm literally hanging out in my apartment in Orlando trying to think, oh God, if I was an animal, what would I be? And I went, well, I mean, a bear. But I'm like a cat, but I'm a bear, like a cat, like a bear, cat, bear, cat. Oh, wait, bear cat's a thing. Google. Binturong. And I have a fellow, this is the only con I know where there's a fellow Binturong, except sometimes confuzzled, and Binturong boy from the UK attends that sometimes. And it's the three of us, and I think Matrice's husband. What?
One in Atlanta, too.
There's a Binturong, is that Matrice's husband?
That's got the full suit.
Yeah, the big blue. I think Matrices made that. I don't know if that's their husband or not. Anyway, there's like four of us in the world. So, yay us. But anyway, that was my thing. So, Rhubarb was driving from Springfield, Missouri, and it was going to take him like 6-7 hours to get here, picking up people, crossing states and stuff. I flew in. You have to fly out in the morning, apparently, in Orlando, so everyone can get there. So I landed like here in Memphis at 7:38 in the morning, and the hotel shuttle picked me up, and I just had my suitcase and no one I knew, not a single soul. I went to the treetop and they're like, oh, breakfast. I said, okay. So I'm eating that and sort of watching people. I get out of breakfast and Max and Tonka find me somehow. People I'd never met accost me like, are you Cosmik? Hey, we're Max, we're Tonka. Come with us, we're gonna go out to get lunch. I'm like, I just finished breakfast. And we went down to the Chinese place. Then we came back and they're like, well, you gotta get a badge. And we went into the dealer's den and I walked all around and I commissioned a badge. And then by the time Rhubarb got here, I had already commissioned a badge, gone through the dealer's den, we got out, and I had done half the con already. Woo! I mean, that's how it happens with everyone, right? That's how y'all got into the fandom.
Right?
Anyway, that story killed some time. But that's how I discovered MFM. And one of the reasons I come back every year, and especially just, it's, I tell people, MFM is not so much a con, it's a family reunion.
Woo!
And it really does hit when Tiger says welcome home every year, this is like the home con. And I don't know, if we had more time, I'd start a discussion and say, you know, what was your first con, and is that your home con, or is it just MFM is so special that this feels like coming home.
Home con is always here.
Always here.
Always.
I wish I had something sentimental to do now, but all I got is this thing.
Right.
Woo!
Matthew Ebel, we've heard, is an educated bird and a dashing chap.
Bucktown Tiger's new norm is to use the question form when he writes his rap.
We all know he won Jeopardy, right?
Right.
Good. Fox Amore, it is true, takes a really epic view when a new song he sets out to pen. Now here's Cosmik
and Rhu,
here to ruin things for you again.
A brand new edition for 2023.
Somehow we've done this. Ring-tailed raccoons do it.
Bears with lots of big balloons do it.
Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Red-coated bats on a whim do it. Also gray-coated.
Even Pim. Let's. All right.
Red-coated bats on a whim do it.
Even people called just Tim do it.
Woo!
Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Now tigers who growl do it, and they turn the crowd on.
Werewolves who howl do it. Every night of the con.
Fill those Woo! Cards out.
That's right.
Blue healers once
in a while, do it. Exit mice and huskies in denial, do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love.
I'm putting some Bruce Hornsby in.
Okay. Oh, that's me.
Yes.
Okay. Some steampunk docks with aplomb, do it.
Paddle foot and panda mom, do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love.
Well, wolves playing flute, do it.
Tigers in a blessed suit, do
Woo!
It. Let's do it. Let's fall in love.
Well, kid furs and babes, do it. Serving cookies and tea.
Frankies and Gabes, do it.
And they've got legal ID.
Dealers in dens, do it. Photographers with a close-up lens, do it.
Woo!
Let's do it. Let's fall in love.
Oh, yeah. Verse 3. Toads who drive trucks, do it.
Con directors throwing ducks, do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love.
It's like MFM herpes.
Dogs far and near, do it.
Folks in unapproved tack gear, do it.
Let's
do it. Let's fall in love.
Our volunteers, when they're asked, do it. And without much fanfare,
rabbits who broadcast, do it. And
they do it live on the air!
Woo!
Yaks from... Oh, I thought you were there.
No, I was doing... Da-da-da-da.
Just a rehearsal anyway, right?
Yaks from Nepal, do it. Charlie Malcontent and Felt Per all do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Let's do it. Let's fall in love.
One more, but we're gonna run a little over. That's because you got time to. There were only six bands, right?
Yeah. Here's one we don't actually know very well, but if this song doesn't get played, it's not quite a con. Funny how connections you make from a distance can change dramatically when you're meeting face to face. But every once in a while you find yourself inside a situation where you don't know who to blame. Could be the excitement in the lobby. State. Could be the liquid in the cup that I keep drinking, but I only got 3 days and you're gone again. Maybe we'll meet in line for something. Maybe we'll meet inside somebody's hotel. Save enough that I can buy the gasoline. And I swear to God, if work don't give me my vacation, I'll go to cons.
They're not doing the other thing. Who did that? Who did that? Who was it? I heard a ruckus.
Okay.
Do we have one?
We don't have one, so we're gonna have to. We're gonna have to. I want to see some audience participation. It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll. But listen closely. Not for very much longer. Drink! It's just a jump to the left. And then a step to the right. Put your hands on your hips. And bring your knees in tight.
But it's the pelvic thrust.
Let's do the time warp again. Let's do the time warp again. It's so dreamy. Oh, fantasy free me. So you can't see. Voyeuristic intention, well secluded, I see all with a bit of a mind for it. You're into the time slip, and nothing could ever be the same. You're spaced out on sensation. Hip.